Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. So as you have seen in the first three videos on expressions, driving animation based on a mathematical curve can be very useful in a whole range of tasks. But sometimes, after creating an expression, you may want to take the mathematical curve and develop it manually. So in part 4 on expression animations in Flame, you'll learn how to take the curve generated by an expression and convert it into an editable keyframed curve. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below. Alternatively, if you're watching the podcast, then please type the displayed link in your web browser. Now load the batch setup and go into this action node with the 2-up view using Alt 2. In this example, if you play the composite, you can see that we have some bouncing text. Now to explain what's happening, if you select the 3D text node and bring up its controls, you can switch to the character axis menu, and I have animated the Y position channel with an expression. The reason for animating the text here and not in an axis node is that there are a few extra animation controls in 3D text that we'll come to at the end of this video. Now hold Shift and click on the channel with the expression to select it. Next, switch to the animation editor, and you'll see the selected channel already framed in the view. To explain the expression, this is generating a sine curve, and its timing has been offset by 10 frames using the evaluation function. This is what creates the vertical movement of the 3D text. Now this movement is continuous, but let's say that at frame 114, you'd like the animation to stop. If you select the curve, you'll notice that no keyframes are available to move or adjust the curve. To edit the curve, you need to convert the expression into a keyframed curve. This is referred to as baking the expression. With the curve still selected, go to the keyframe tab and click the curve functions pull-down menu. Choose to bake the curve. The expression is converted into a keyframed curve, and by default, you get a keyframe per frame to maintain the integrity of the curve. This may not be totally workable in its current state, so the next step is to simplify the curve. Click the curve functions pull-down menu again and choose to simplify the curve. Next, increase the value for the curve functions and you can decide how much to simplify your animation curve. Now that the curve is more manageable, hold D and delete the last two keyframes at the end of the curve. If you play the composite again, you'll see the initial animation from the expression, and eventually the 3D object will settle in its final position. So that's how you can bake or convert an expression into an editable curve. But as an extra tip, you can also use the bake function to convert an extrapolation into a keyframed curve. Now to quickly finish off this example, exit the animation menu and go back to the character axis menu. At the moment, all the text characters move at the same time. But if you increase the cascade value, you can offset the animation of each letter by a set number of frames. Playing the animation one last time, you can see how this creates a completely different look using the small hidden feature in the 3D text geometry. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for updates and new videos, and comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thanks for watching.